which is very important for a healthy life being. Whatever we say, Raja Yoga, meditation and all other forms of yoga, we are basically targeted to improve one's lifestyle, health status and state of life, the flow of life. Trend of reduction in LHF ratio, sympathetic vagal balance is stimulated, sympathetic vagal balance is attenuated. This indicates that the person is more flexible with the coping solutions, say the situations, and more cooperative to the scenario that is coming to them. Better relaxation is indicated by skin conductance. Whenever we get tense, skin conductance changed, skin conductance increases. That is a technique used for lie detector. The skin conductance is a very prominent physiological marker of relaxation, and particularly for meditation also, any sort of meditation, skin conductance has been proven to be a good parameter. In our study also we have seen that skin conductance revealed the effect of Raja Yoga meditation very properly. EEG, significant improvement in terms of increased alpha and reduced beta, is again the concern of consequence of Raja Yoga meditation practice that has been the good effect on occipital EEG. Next. This can help us to design the strategies by psychophysiological well-being, which often we are exposed to extreme environmental conditions. In DRDO, it has got a good application because we can employ these techniques to make our stress-induced personnel, where they are at high altitude, extreme altitude, isolation, low intensity complete areas like psychological stress. In these situations, if they can be allowed to practice Raja Yoga meditation, at least some sort of relaxation, some sort of well-being, some sort of remediation of their current scenario will be there. This is a recording of the recordings we have taken. See the participants. We have make the patient prepared for the recording, and you can skip. Now electrodes are being probed and the recording starts. The recording is in progress. The topmost model is EEG recording. This is the third phase recording. You see the improvement, as I have earlier showed also. I want to acknowledge some persons. Number one, Didi Chakradhari and Dr. Sashibala Singh, Director DIPAS, who has given me the opportunity to do this work and concern all these things. Lovely Didi has been a constant inspiration and good moral support to me, And whatever has been arranged at Shaktinagar and Deraval Nagar centers has been organized by Lovely Didi and Puja Didi on all two more Didis. Those days have been memorable for me, how we manage patients and how they used to come in the shifts, and we all make them happy and then record them and show them. Everyone have their query, how is our recording, how is our recording. We kept on telling, we'll tell you. And like this we have completed the studies. And Dr. Sushil Chandra sir, who has given all supports from starting from recording and coming here also. And all those names we have, whoever the participants have been present here or not, I acknowledge them wholeheartedly. उनको बिना ये काम सफल नहीं हो पाता. हम तहे दिल से उनके शुक्रगुजार हैं, जो भी हमारे पार्टिसिपेंट बने हैं, जो भी हमारे रिकॉर्डिंग के लिए पार्टिसिपेंट. और मुगल भाई को भी बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद हमें यहाँ पे मौका देने और ये चांस देने के लिए कि हम अपना डेटा शेयर कर सकें. धन्यवाद. ओम शांति.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Abhirup Chatterjee ji, and aapke saath aapke department mein Dr. Mantu Shah, who is actually in charge of Department of Yoga Research on CARTY by abbreviation CARTY. So unko bhi bahut bahut dil se thanks. So we go to the next presentation, which is from Defense Institute of Psychological Research. This would be done by Dr. Arunima Gupta ji and Dr. Nishi Mishraji jointly. So I request Dr. Arunima and Dr. Nishi ji will be doing it, right? Sorry. So Nishi ji, you're welcome to present your ideas.
Respected sisters and brothers, Om Shanti, and a very pleasant morning to all of you. At the outset, I would like to thank the organizers of SPARK to give us an opportunity to present the findings of the pilot study titled Effect of Raj Yoga on Affective and Cognitive Functions, that was carried out by DIPR on this holy platform. Now to start with the study, I'll just let you know as to how we'll do that. I'll give an introductory part of the study followed by the methodology that was followed. And thereafter, the findings of the study and the implications shall be presented by Dr. Arunima Gupta. A famous scientist, Albert Einstein, has said, he's rightly said that science without religion is lame and religion without science is blind. And just emphasizing on that, he's also elaborated that although scientists have been pursuing a number of research work, they are still intrigued by the fact there is something which is more powerful, that is having more energy beyond which they cannot do research, and that is that supreme force that is there, that is existing, and that is what he has said, a spirit that is vastly superior to that of man, and one in the face of which our modest powers must feel humble. So I start with that. And again, it has been reiterated by Honorable Dalai Lama that with the ever-growing impact of science on our lives, religion and spirituality have a greater role to play in reminding us of our humanity. When we use these two words, spirituality and religiosity, there is a slight difference between the two. When we talk about religion, it means it's an organized practice, an organized set of beliefs and values that is being followed by a set of people. That is what we mean by religion. But when we use the word spirituality, it is more encompassing, it is more broad in nature, that comprises more of the positive aspect of human being. Herein comes optimism, herein comes hope, herein comes happiness. So we have tried to look into our study, when we talk about the affective parameters, we are talking about both the negative aspect of emotions as well as the positive effect of emotions. So we are going to talk about these two when we are talking about the affective parameters that we have touched upon. People who are spiritual, they are either doing meditation or yoga, as has been seen. And when we talk about meditation, it's an act of spiritual contemplation, and it denotes self-experience, self-realization, and a specific practice to achieve the discovery of the ultimate truth. And there are different forms of yoga that are practiced, but in this study, we focused on Raj Yoga practice, which is the mental connection between the soul and the supreme soul that empowers the self to rule the mind, sense organs, and the body. And of course, all of us know that this practice does not involve any act of austerities or penances or renouncing one's household. So before starting with the study, we thought of reviewing the literature, and as was rightly pointed out by Dr. Abhirup, that we found that a lot of literature is existing on the effect of yoga, different forms of yoga, that is hatha yoga and the various pranayam, meditation and all, on affective and cognitive parameters. But none of the studies were related with the effect of Raj Yoga on these two parameters specifically. So I'm just presenting a glimpse of some of the studies that are existing and which have looked into these two parameters, but they have been done on either hatha yoga, pranayam, and various other, you can say, forms of yoga that are existing. So we see that Epstein et al., they found that meditation has personal health enhancing effects, and similarly, Atwood and Moulton and all, they found that meditation helps the patient to develop patience, to be aware of the problem, it promotes a non-judgmental attitude, it helps the patient to come to terms with what is. So a lot of beneficial effects of meditation have been noticed in literature. Similarly, a number of Indian studies are also available, but they are on yoga, yoga practice in general, that has been found to reduce neuroticism, anxiety, hostility. These are some of the variables that we have taken into consideration in our psychological study. And it has been found to induce relaxation, and it has been regarded as a good therapeutic technique. And similarly, the effect of yoga has been found on cognitive functions, fatigue, mood, quality of life in healthy seniors. And a number of other studies have been done on patients also. It has been found to result in greater decrease in scores on anger, confusion, tension and depression. That was a study on hatha yoga that was there. It has been found to result in decrease in mood disturbance and stress symptoms in cancer patients. And significant improvement has been noticed in tension, anxiety, depression, dejection, anger, hostility in psychiatric patients practicing yoga. Again, pranayam, number of studies are there, and it has also been found to result in positive effects. A significant decrease in heart rate, high scores on life satisfaction, lower scores in excitability, openness, emotionality. So number of studies you can see are existing, but none of them you will find for Raj Yoga. So I think it's high time that this practice has been existing, and we have not documented it. So we should start documenting the effect of Raj Yoga. So with that premise, we started this study with two major objectives. Firstly, to study the impact of duration of Raj Yoga meditation practice on affective and cognitive functions. And secondly, to compare the beginners and experts of Raj Yoga meditation on affective and cognitive functions. Wherein we hypothesized that there will be a significant effect of duration of Raj Yoga meditation practice on affective and cognitive functions, and there will be a significant difference in scores on affective and cognitive functions of beginners and experts. The design that we followed was an exploratory study using the pre- and post-test treatment design. And the study was conducted in three phases on three groups of Raj Yoga practitioners. That is, for all the phases, there were three groups. For phase one, that is the baseline phase, there were three groups from 0 to 1 year. Group two was 1 to 5 years of Raj Yoga practitioners, and group three, above 5 years of Raj Yoga practitioners. Similar was the case for phase two and phase three. Now the sample was more definitely initially, but we had to exclude all those samples which had not completed the questionnaire that we had given to them totally. So that is why the numbers will be found lesser over here as compared to those who had reported. Phase 1, 105, phase 2, 54, and phase 3 is 55. And accordingly, group 1, group 2, and group 3, we try to segregate in each phase. Now the tools that were used for the affective parameters. First one was the NeoPIR scale, the neuroticism scale, which was basically used for measuring the negative emotions as I was talking about. See, a small description of the scale is given, wherein individuals high on this factor, that is on anger, guilt, disgust, fear, sadness, etc., they are prone to have irrational ideas. They are regarded as having irrational ideas. They are less able to control the impulses and cope poorly than those than others with stress. So this was the scale, and this scale is measuring these six facets, that is anxiety, angry hostility, depression, self-consciousness, impulsiveness, and vulnerability. Next slide. The other scale, that was the happiness scale. Now this, herein comes the positive emotion that we tried to assess. So happiness scale was a very small four item scale which measures global subjective happiness of an individual, wherein two items they ask respondents to characterize themselves using both absolute ratings and ratings relative to peers, and the other two items they offer brief descriptions of happy and unhappy individuals and ask respondents the extent to which each characterization describes them. So it was a small scale that was used. Now the hope scale that is there, these are all standardized scales which have been used before on the Indian sample with other groups, definitely not with Raj Yoga, but with other studies we have used them. The adult hope scale, yes. Yes, please. It measures cognitive model of hope, and it defines hope as a positive motivational state that is based on an interactively derived sense of successful agency, goal-directed energy, and pathways, that is planning to meet goals. It is again a small scale. It comprises 12 items, with 4 items measuring pathway thinking and 4 items agency thinking and 4 other filler items. So participants, they were asked to respond to each item using an 8-point scale ranging from definitely false to definitely true, and the scale takes only a few minutes to complete. Next slide. And the last thing that was measured was the quality of life scale, which assesses an individual's quality of life through self-report of the importance that they attach to each of the 16 life domains, and it measures an individual's response on a 7-point scale. So these were some of the tools that were used, next slide, for measuring the affective parameters. Now the tools that were used, next slide, for the cognitive parameters, wherein we tried to measure the visual memory, that is the verbal and the non-verbal part both. And the test that was used, yes, this was a figure that was shown to the individuals and thereafter it was withdrawn after a few seconds, and they were asked to draw this figure from memory. And you may see that this figure is a very complex figure, but some of the individuals had done so well that we were really surprised, because we can't do it. It is, for us, it is impossible. So a person who is having a lot of concentration, a lot of memory that is there, visual memory that is called, will be able to do it. And participants had done it very nicely. And the next thing, this was the verbal learning part, wherein we had shown a list of words and the list of words were withdrawn, and then later on they were asked to write the words that were shown to them. Next slide. And we also tried to assess the attention and concentration part, wherein we had given them the letter cancellation test. Yes, it was from the enhanced neuropsychological battery. It assesses visual scanning responses, speed and sustained attention. And the subject was presented with letters of English alphabets. A lot of English alphabets were there, and some of the alphabets were chosen, and they were asked to cancel those letters. and errors of omission, how many times they had omitted a particular letter out of the letters that were shown to them, and how many times they had marked other letters as compared to the letters that were shown. That is, errors of omission and errors of commission that was assessed. So with this, I would now request Arunima ma'am to come on the dais and present the findings of the study, which were really interesting, and you'll find them very interesting. Yes, ma'am.
See, now as you have seen that what all we have done, the kind of test we have used for assessing the affective and cognitive domains of the practitioners, and here I would like to take your attention that when we talk of the group, you may find that group had a quite a varied characteristics. So sample characteristics, if you look at, we had male and female, both the groups. We had education level varying from high school to the professional group. Marital status, we had a combination of unmarried and married practitioners. Then if you look at the occupation, we had a combination of students and up to the housewife. The housewives also were included, business people and service people. So quite a heterogeneous group that we have got in the process. And previous knowledge of yoga practice, Raja Yoga practice, there you will find there were set of participants who had previous knowledge and there were set of participants who had no knowledge of Raja Yoga earlier. Age of, average number of hours in a month, that has also been taken into consideration to see that what all effect it has got on the affective and cognitive functions. When we come to the findings, I must tell you that these are some of the preliminary findings which we have got in the process, and our aim of today presenting it to see that what are your experiences, your knowledge and your inputs are going to contribute to look into this data further and go for a further greater finer details of a research process and look into that how this process can further be enhanced and enriched in. So coming to the next slide, please. So coming to that, seeing on the affective and cognitive functions, the three groups were there and three phases, baseline, 0 day, 30 day and 60 day process that we have seen, and number of years of practice is 0 to 1 year, 1 to 5 and more than 5 years. Next slide, please. Now coming to see the effect of Raja Yoga on affective functions. See, if you see the groups, the pre and post, the phase 1 and phase 2 means baseline with 30 days of practice. What you find, the number of participants are comparatively less. Reason being, as Dr. Nishi has told, that we have eliminated all those protocols where that informations were incorrect, thereby that it should not influence the results. So we have kept only those informations, those protocols where the information was complete. But what we have found in the process, that still there were some sparks of that there are fine improvements or some significant differences are coming. Then we have reached to the next stage, progress to the next stage. Next slide, please. See, then on the phase 1, phase 2 comparison, we have compared them on the scale of hope, happiness and quality of life. And what we have observed, there was not much of a no significant difference obtained in the sample. Then the third aspect was cognitive function. And what we have found in the cognitive function, that all the cognitive variables have shown a significant improvement in phase 1 to phase 2, means 0 to 30 days of practice. And that was quite an encouraging thing to see that cognitive functions have shown such a significant improvement. Now coming to comparing 30 days to 60 days. So then what we have found again on affective functions, the number of places we have found that significant differences were coming, and the quite a good glimpse of that it was reducing, the mean was reducing in few of the many of these cells. And then on the happiness and quality of life scale, we could see only on happiness there was a significant difference. And that is how we have started contemplating on that how this affective aspect and the hope, happiness and quality of life is associated or is related. That was the point we have started working on that. Then coming to 2 and 3, again in this phase of 30 days to 60 days, there was a quite a good significant improvement in the cognitive functions, not in all as we have seen in the first, but in many of the variables. Now we have tried to compare, let's compare, remove the stage 2 of 30 days and see baseline to 60 days data. And again we have started getting little more encouraging results that yes, there is a issue of effective functions getting improved if more and more practice is being there. And then, but when it comes to hope, happiness and quality of life, we have found that happiness sometimes comes out as a significant, with a significant effect as compared to any other hope or quality of life issue. Then on cognitive function, again, if we compare 1 to 3rd stage, the significant improvements on cognitive functions were observed. And now coming to when we have put all the three groups together, right, the three groups of 0 to 1, 1 to 5 and more than 5, and what we have found that on all the effective components of effective functions, there was a marked significant difference, and you will observe that from group 1 to 2 and 3, their consistent decrease in all these facets of affect, the negative facets, what we call the anxiety, depression, angry hostility and all. It's a very consistent result that this statistics and this has shown. Coming to again for these three groups, we have found happiness comes out as a significant this thing, and though improvement is shown in all other, like talking about hope or quality of life, but happiness has a significant difference. Coming to cognitive functions, you have seen that in every group there was an improvement in cognitive function, therefore there is no intergroup differences found. What has happened? No. This one. See what has happened, I'll tell you. This is what my, but not significant. What is very important in this? No, but what I say, once it is non-significant and we know the sample size also, we have to further work on this. All these things, what we say, attention 5.80, it's fine. It is with regard to omission and commission, the errors that has been committed. Again, I will come back to the sample size and then I will say these reflections where all it is not significant or showing a decline needs to be seen by enhancing the sample size and thereby seeing that what picture it portrays. What? I'll come to the limitations of the study and all, right? Then coming that when we have found that there are tremendous intergroup differences and consistently showing an on-effective domain, then we have thought let's divide the group, the sample, into two. One is a beginner in the Raja Yoga practice and the other one as an expert. So how we have divided? We have taken 0 to 2 and 10 and above years. And what it reflects that yes, there is a consistent decline in all these negative affects. And therefore that gives us a very encouraging direction and lead to work on this and see that how, you know, best kind of a research papers and best kind of a these approaches can be now seen from a scientific perspective and can be introduced in the Raja Yoga meditation, which can further be quantified in various forms. Then coming to these aspects, when we have compared the beginners and expert, we found there was a hope and the happiness, both concepts were there and improved. And this is where started giving us an indication that if we want to go further in this studies, we have to go for a kind of a approach where the beginners and the practitioners can be compared. And it gives a very, very clear-cut indications about the impact. Now coming the second part of the performer, we have used to take the subjective views of the participants and the practitioners on how the Raja Yoga affects their various areas of life.